Hello students, today we are going to start with the writing skill topic, that is summary writing. Summary writing question comes in your exam for 3 marks. So let's start. Student, first to make you understand how to write a summary, first you should know what summary means. Summary means to summarize or sum up the passage in a few words, that is 1/10 of the given passage. For example, if a passage is of 600 words, your summary will be of 60 words only. It is the gist, the message of the passage. You should keep in mind that summary should contain main points. It should be very brief. It should contain all important information given in the passage. And you have to end the passage with a message conveyed by the author. And you also should give a title to the passage. And keep in mind that word limit should be strictly followed. Let's see what they have told you regarding summary writing in the text. Brevity is the soul of wit is one of the countless maxims coined by William Shakespeare. Now, this is a proverb. Brevity is the soul of wit. It means the funniest and wittiest statement are short and to the point than a longer drawn out statement. Maxims here means a short statement expressing a general truth. So this short proverb, it expresses a general truth and it is written by William Shakespeare. It is relevant to speaking as well as writing. Means while speaking also we should be very precise. We should speak to the point, and same goes for writing. Brevity or concision. Concision here means using only the words necessary to convey the idea. Brevity or concision is the cutting out of the unnecessary words while conveying idea, means to cut out, to remove the unnecessary words, to only use the required words, the main words. It aims to enhance communication, to improve your communication by eliminating redundancy. Redundancy means no longer needed or useful words, means to cut out all those words, to omit them. Without omitting important information, means you should not omit the important information that you should keep in mind. Summary writing is one of its kind that has been described as one of the elementary principle of writing, means one of the important principles of writing. To speak what is required and to write what is necessary is a requisite towards the development of language skill. Means whatever is required to speak only that, and whatever is necessary to write only that. It is very important form of, you can say, development of your language skill. It is important to be brief in written expression. Means unnecessary information should not be written. To express in brief the main points of a written record is the summary writing skill, and that can be developed by practice. Means that can be developed only by practicing it. Summarizing has a definite purpose. The purpose of a summary is to give the reader a clear objective picture of the original text. Means it makes the reader understand what is the main idea of the passage here. What does the writer want to convey to you? Most importantly, the summary restates only the main points of the text or a lecture without giving example details such as date, numbers and statistics. Means only important points are being summed up here in your passage. Examples are not written. Now here they have given you some do's and don'ts. First we'll see what you are supposed to do while writing a summary. Read and reread the passage. You have to read in your exam when you get a passage and they ask you to summarize it. Usually the comprehension passage only they ask you to summarize. So you have to read the passage twice. You have to understand what does the writer want to tell you in the passage. and you have to read the instruction given there. They tell you, they give you a word limit there. So you have to keep in mind all that. Find exactly what you need to summarize. Means when you understand what is the main idea of the passage, what they want to convey to you, then only you will understand what you are supposed to write here. Identify the main idea to the process of asking question. Form short sentences on your own. You don't have to pick up the line as it is from the passage and write down. You have to, when you pick up the main points, you have to write short sentences in your own words. Connect the sentences using linkers. Remove the redundant word, means the words which are not required, and sentences from the key sentences. Omit the details, means they will give you some examples or dates and all. So you have to omit all that. Only the main sentences that you have to pick up, and you have to frame those sentences in your own words again, removing the unnecessary words. Avoid your own interpretation. You don't give your own interpretation to the passage here. Now what you're not supposed to do. Means you're not supposed to include any other information other than the information given in the passage. You should not exclude any information. All important information should be there in your summary. You don't have to add anything. You don't need to give comment, your opinion on that, and no need to give examples also. Now they have given you one article as an example of how to write a summary. Let's do that. First, I'll read and make you understand the passage, and then we will write the summary for the passage. Let's start. Learning disability is an umbrella term for a wide variety of learning problems. Means important term. For the wide variety of learning problems. Children with learning disorder might be labeled as slow learners. Means those children who are not able to learn properly, they are termed as what? Slow learners. But they are as smart as everyone else. But here the article tells you, but the students are very smart. They just need to be taught in a proper environment conducive to the learning speed and level. Means they also can learn everything, but the speed and level is different from the other students. Or you can say a bit slow from other students. So you have to keep in that, you have to keep that in mind. Observations of a child over a period of time by parents at home and teachers in school can provide valuable information about the way a child is able to learn and function in all the ways that he should be able to at his age and level. Means the parents, when they observe it at home, at means how much time he takes to learn something, or if a teacher also observes in the school, so this will help you to know what is the time required for the child to learn a specific thing. There may be certain apparent problems while reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, and dealing with maths. Means the child might find problems here. Once these problems are identified, it is time for proper investigation. Once you come to know what problem the child is facing while learning all this subject, or you can say the particular writing, listening, or speaking skill, then you can try to investigate how to solve those problems. It is important in order to clarify specific learning disorder and also rule out any other issue affecting the student's educational progress. It is very important to find out what the disorder the child is going through and how to rule out it. Investigation may reveal various types of disorder, and when you relate it to certain skills like reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, you find there are certain disorder, certain types of disorders. They are dyslexia, dysgraphia, dyscalculia, specific reading disability, auditory processing disorder, etc. Auditory processing disorder is also known as central auditory processing disorder, is a condition that affects the sound that travels unimpeded through the ear. is processed and interpreted by the brain. Individuals with APD do not recognize subtle differences between sound and word. Yeah, the child is not able to differentiate between sound and word. Dyscalculia is a condition that affects a person's ability to understand numbers and learn math, signs and symbol, while dysgraphia affects a person's handwriting abilities, a fine motor skills. Means certain disorders, here you come to know what is the effect. Dyslexia is a learning disorder affecting reading, language-based processing skill like reading fluency, decoding, recall, writing and sometimes even speech. Many aspects of speaking, listening, reading, writing and arithmetic overlap and build on the same brain capabilities. It is not surprising that people can be diagnosed with more than one learning disability. Means it is not that the child will have only one problem of one disorder here. There can be other one or more than one also. For example, the ability to understand language underlies learning to speak. Therefore, any disorder that hinders the ability to understand language will also interfere with the development of speech. Means if you are not able to understand, how will you speak? So it goes with one, goes with other, which in turn hinders learning to read and write. Attention deficit hyperactive disorder includes difficulty in staying focused and paying attention, restlessness and difficulty in controlling behavior. There are many other learning disabilities that can be identified in the normal classroom at school level. Such problem can be solved to a great extent by using various methods and treatment. Now, this all learning disability can be identified in the normal classroom only at the school level. It is not special, treatment is not required for those students, means special classroom and nothing like that. In normal classroom also, these children can be dealt with. Such problem can be solved to a great extent using various methods and treatments if diagnosed at early stage. Means they can be various methods and treatment can be used to cure those students from those problem. Inclusion in education is one of the ways to solve the problem of children with learning disorder. Means those you can say methods should be included in the learning system only. In a mixed ability classroom with effective teaching methods and conducive environment, a child with learning disability can progress in not only education but also social interaction. Here in this article we come to know that they are saying in the mixed ability classroom, means in a classroom there are so many children who are, you can say, the mental level of those students are different. So if the teacher uses effective teaching method and the atmosphere is also conducive here in the classroom, so the child who is having this disability problem can also be treated in the same classroom. But also not only education, he can progress not only in education but also in social interaction. Implementation of inclusive classroom may vary. Means how the method is being implemented in the classroom, that can vary from teacher to teacher, but the purpose will be achieved. Means the child will achieve progress here. Unfortunately, our country is less open to inclusive learning for children with learning disability. Means in our country, you will not find so many, that type of method being used. Unless handled efficiently, this disorder often transforms to a condition like anxiety and depression. Means if you use this type of method in the classroom itself, the child will progress. But if you don't handle it properly, that disorder can transform into anxiety and depression. Parents, teachers, educators and stakeholders must insist on the need to uplift children with learning disability. These children need to be handled carefully in their own space. They need love, encouragement, moral support so that they can emerge with great self-confidence, self-worth and determination. Now student, I have read the entire paragraph or article for you all. Now, from this paragraph, we come to know that the passage is mainly about learning disability and how we should handle the students of suffering with this problem with care. So here you can say the title of the your passage can be learning disability. Now, from the first paragraph, you can say the first sentence, learning disability is an umbrella term for many learning problems. They have given wide variety of learning problems. So instead of wide variety, you can write here many learning problems. Now, instead of explaining everything here, we will directly write here what are those problems, like reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, and dealing with maths. These are the problems. Now, what here they are saying here, that these problems should be identified and investigated. Now, see, first here they are telling here, it is important in order to clarify, see here, once these problems are identified, it is time for proper investigation. Means what? The writer wants to tell you that this problem should be identified and investigated. So that one important point we will note down. Then you can say, here they have also mentioned the problems are given here. We will not write all those problems here. Means what is the meaning of each disorder, not necessary to write in the summary here. Here you will write here that if the child can be diagnosed with more than one also. See, it is not surprising that people can be diagnosed with more than one learning disability. That this is also very important statement, so you have to add that also in your summary. Now, after that, they are saying here, this problem can be dealt with various methods in the regular classroom itself. No need of special classroom from these students. So that also sentence you will include here, that various methods can be used in regular classroom itself. And one of the ways in inclusion and implementation may be vary. Means here they are saying here, implementation of inclusive classroom may vary, but the purpose will be achieved. This is also important here. So you can write here, implementation of inclusion may vary, but it has a positive effect on learning disabled child. After that, they are telling you that though the idea is very useful, but unfortunately in our country we find it is not available or it is not commonly used. So that also you should mention in your paragraph, and you can also mention that if it is been used, then what will happen? It will help the child to progress. And you should also mention the last line here, that they need love, encouragement, and moral support so that they can emerge, or you can write here, become great, self-confident, self-worth, and determined person. I told you the important points, and according to the important points, now see, this is the paragraph, means the summary of the paragraph which we had read. The points which I told you, same points you will find in this paragraph written here. See, learning disability handle with care. Learning disability is an umbrella term for many learning problems like reading, writing, listening, speaking, reasoning, maths, and other physical and motor difficulties. These problems can be identified and investigated. A child can be diagnosed with more than one problem, like the problems are given. Such disorder can be dealt with various methods in the regular classroom, and one of the ways is inclusion. Then implementation of inclusion may vary, but it has positive effect. And though the idea of inclusion is not popular in our country, still it is useful to handle such children. And along with the methods and techniques, they also need encouragement, moral support to progress with self-confidence and determination. As I told you that whatever your passage is, the summary should be only 1/10 of the passage. Now our passage was of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 paragraphs. And we have just picked out the important points from the paragraph, what the writer wants to convey to you, and we have written the summary here. Now student, for your practice, one more passage is given here. You have to read the passage and write its summary according to the steps given, which we have seen here. I want you to do this for practice. After that, see here. Cut the redundant words, means the words which is not, are not required. Now see here, circle around can also be just told as circle. Write down can be written as only write. Added bonus can be written as bonus. Get to the point as quickly as possible is really to get to the point. Close proximity means close, and during the course of means during. Now they want you to write 5 more example of redundant words. Now I'll tell you, like collaborated together can be just said as collaborated. Past experience can be said as experience. The reason why can be told as reason. Plus in addition can be told as in addition or addition. Close proximity can be said as proximity. So here 6 example they have given, 5 I told you just now. You have to find out 5 more examples. Then avoid adverbs. That's usually a good thing to do. Instead of using the word usually, you can also say that's a good thing to do. So in the same way, they want to tell you that there are some adverbs where there is no need for us to use those adverbs. We can skip them. After that, one word substitution, like the life story of a man written by himself is known as what? Autobiography. A sound that cannot be heard is what does it mean? Inaudible. A list of book means catalog. A sentence whose meaning is unclear means ambiguous. Now they are telling you to find more examples. We'll see. I'll tell you, like the killing of oneself can be one word for that will be suicide. Study of earth and rocks means geology. One who loves his country, patriot. Expressive in the use of words, eloquent. Writing of one's life means biography. So you have to find more such words that will increase your vocabulary. Now next one is use of noun in apposition. Apposition is a grammatical construction in which two elements, normally noun phrase, a place, are placed side by side, with one element serving to identify the other in different way. The two elements are said to be in opposition. Opposition can be used to make a compound sentence short and simple. Now see the sentence. Neha is their eldest child. She is very intelligent. Now noun in opposition, how you will use? Neha, their eldest child, is very intelligent. You will not use the word is their eldest child and she is very intelligent. You have cut out the other things. See here Neha and their eldest child are the same person. See here, Neha, their eldest child. Who is the eldest child? Neha. So it is the same. So why to repeat it again? You will just put comma there. Neha, their eldest child. Then, and she is also not required. You will just write, is very intelligent. Now see, for transforming the complex into simple by using phrases like to, or using noun phrase instead of clause. We will see here now. See, Nagpur is the city where oranges grow. Now here there are two clauses. Nagpur is the city, and the other subordinate clause is where oranges grow. Now you have to change the complex sentence. There are two clauses means it is a complex sentence. So you have to change that complex sentence into simple. So what you will say? Oranges grow in Nagpur. Now see the next one. The old man is so weak that he cannot walk. Here also it is complex sentence. So to change that, so if it is so and that is used in the sentence, you can use the word too here. So you can say the old man is too weak to walk. Now they have give you 5 sentences. Let's do that. See, Mr. Rohit is the member and he is also the director. Now this person, Mr. Rohit, he is the same person. He is member and also the director. So while changing the sentence into simple, what you will write? Mr. Rohit, the member, is also the director. Understood? What you will write? Mr. Rohit, comma, the member, is also the director. Then next one, the room is so small that it cannot accommodate many people. So here you will use this one, too. The room is too small. You will, instead of so, you will write, the room is too small to accommodate many people. Next one, you have to prove that you are innocent. Here it is a complex sentence. You have to prove, the main clause, that you are innocent, subordinate clause. So you have to change it into a one simple clause. So how you will change the sentence? You have to prove that you are innocent. You can just say, prove your innocence. What you will say in a simple sentence? Prove your innocence. Next one, he was late, so he walked in a great hurry. Now here also, he was late, main clause, so he walked in a great hurry, subordinate clause. So main clause and subordinate clause means a complex sentence. Now you have to change it into simple. For some sentences, while from complex changing into simple, you can also use ing form of the verb. You can say, being late, he walked in a hurry. Being late, he walked in a great hurry. I hope you understood now how to do it, how to change the complex into simple. I hope you have understood this. Thank you.